Coming up, action from the Winter Universiade in Granada, where sports fans are having plenty to savour. Alpine skiers had to deal with tough conditions in the men's giant slalom. In women's ice hockey, there was a bronze medal up for grabs between China and Japan. Look out too for action in curling and in short track skating, where Universiade records were set to tumble. To the slopes of the Sierra Nevada and the men's giant slalom, some terrible weather conditions. In fact, the jury deciding to start the giant race for the men from the slalom start. Vertical drop in this case, 255 metres. We're at 2,500 metres altitude. There you see the air temperatures, -5, and very difficult conditions for the skiers to negotiate. We'll look at Rocco Della Santa from the University of Parma in Italy, 23 years old. Best performance this season was sixth in the giant slalom in a university race in Foppolo, 24th in the European Cup in Crans-Montana this season. You see the Italian in action. And Della Santa stopping the clock. It's 48.18. A pretty decent performance that was from the Italian Rocco Della Santa, putting him in with a real chance of a medal. Jonas Fabbra, gold medalist in Trentino in the GS, 21 years old from Grenoble, studies at the Joseph Fourier University. 2 years ago, beat the Frenchman Thibaut Favreau and Giulio Bosca to win the gold. And again, France and Italy would dominate this discipline, saying he's got ambitions to get on the World Cup circuit. And Fabra was top of the pile, in fact, after the first run. Remember, two runs. A really smooth ski it was. 47.68, the time that had him on top after the first round. So looking good for France then. Is Michelangelo Tentori from the University of Milan, 23 years old. Now, he won the men's Super G earlier this week. A man in form. He's had a giant slalom, top 10 finishes in university races in San Moritz and Fondo Grande Folgaria this season. And he put himself in with a real chance as well. As you see, Tentori, 48.31, he would finish with this ski, powering down the end of the slope. Really tough conditions, but that put him third best after the first run. So this is how it stood then. Fabra, Del Sante, Tentori, the top three, with Max Morneau and Cedric Nogier. But in the slaloms and the giant slalom, anything can happen, really. It's all about consistency. Let's look at Robin Buffet from the University of Savoie, 14th in the European Cup slalom in Germany in February. And he was 8th after the first. Thought he had a chance here, the Frenchman. And he would end up being the 8th after the second run as well. So there you have it, some consistency. 49.45, he would stop the clock on the second run for a total of 138.1, giving him a real chance at this stage of a medal. But no one could stop this man again, Michelangelo Tentori. Remember, he was third after the first run. And another really good ski for him. You can see the conditions were difficult, but he would stop the clock in 49.15 seconds, getting the better of Buffet and putting himself ahead with just two skiers to go. There you have it, the end of Tentori's run. putting him in with a great chance, certainly of a medal. But which colour would it be? There were two races left to go. 1:37.46 is total time. It was time for the other Italian, Rocco Del Santa. Second after the first run, but he would struggle in the second. Conditions just getting tougher and tougher, as you can see, struggling to maintain his line was Del Santa in the University of Parma. Knew that he had a great chance of a medal second, but anything can really happen on the second run, and he would only be 14th best on the second run, which scuppered his chances of a gold, but still a fine performance it was from Rocco Del Santa. His total time at 1:37.81.
Coming to the finish line, Rocco Del Santa from Italy. The second place.
So the tension was really mounting. Jonas Fabra looking to retain the gold medal. He was last to go. Could he handle the conditions? That was the question from the Frenchman based in Grenoble, up in the French Alps, a great place to practice skiing. But unfortunately for Fabra, he couldn't handle the second run. A few slips, a few technical errors, and he would only be 22nd best on that second run. There are more than 100 competitors here from 27 countries. And it was just getting tougher and tougher for Fabra, the Frenchman. He might have been best on the first run, but he was way down on the second. Fabra stopping the clock in 50.32 for a total time of 1:38 dead. And that meant a second gold medal for Michelangelo Tentordi. What a week it's been for him. Fabra with the bronze and Rocco Del Santa taking a silver home to Italy. A great day for Italy then, with a 1-2, Jonas Fabra picking up the bronze for France. Women's ice hockey action now, the 17 competition reaching the business end. China faced Japan at the Sports Palace with a bronze medal at stake. China won silver on home ice in Harbin in 2009. 2013, they didn't enter a team. Back in Trentino, Japan reached the semi-finals, losing to the USA 3-1 in the bronze medal match. Could they go better this time out? Japan's coach, Yujiro Kasahara. China, guided by Fukuan Wong. Starting goaltender for Japan was Nana Fujimoto. Yuking Wong looking to stop shots for China. Japan playing in the black. Remember, China had lost their semi-final 10-0 to Russia. A bit of a humiliation, that one. Teams had met in Group 8. Japan winning all their games. They'd beaten China 1-0. Goal from Mai Mori on that occasion. There was a first goal, 11 minutes in. Japan going ahead on a power play goal. And Mika Hori, this after Xin Feng had been given a 2-minute penalty for holding. Japan had lost their own semi-final 5-2 to Canada. Goals from Mayu Iwasaki and Chiho Osawa in that game. China made it 1-1 here. Shuang Lu also on a power play after Nachi Fujimoto had been ordered off the ice. 1-1 then. We were in for an exciting game. We'll take a look at this. In the last minute of the first period, a blow for Japan. Forward Mayu Iwasaki off the ice for 25 minutes because of this piece of kicking. But China failing to take advantage of their extra player. Iwasaki off the ice for 25 minutes, but China only managed two shots in the second period. Neni Sugisawa with a great chance, but a fine save from China goaltender Wong. Then Japan retaking the lead, Shiori Kiyoki with that vital goal. And this was when the tide was turning back towards Japan. Key goal there from Kiyoki. later in the second period. China's Menying Zhang was denied an equaliser. And right at the end of the second, Haruna Yonayama going close. So the onus on China to do something to get that bronze medal. Chiho Asawa, another save from Wang, one of 22 on the day for her. She was certainly the busier of the two goaltenders. Japan had a chance with Mika Hori nearly making it 3-1 hit with 15 minutes left on the clock. This was a tense, nervy affair, a medal up for grabs. China had a chance, Minghui Kong here, but it stayed at 2-1. Japan also with an opportunity, Haruna Yonayama, an all-action figure, and she nearly scored there. But look at this, Japan sealing the bronze in the 54th minute. Haruna Moritake making it 3-1. Japan having 25 shots in all, including 14 in the third period. Only 11 in the whole game for China. Those goals for Hori, Kiyoki and Moritake. Russia facing Canada in the final. Heartbreak then for China, who travel home without a medal. Japan delighted with the bronze. Women's curling saw Switzerland as the underdogs against Canada in the semi-finals. This is at the Fuentenueva Pavilion in Granada. 10 teams entered the women's competition. Norway, Great Britain, the USA, Japan and Spain all had negative records eliminated. Switzerland went 5-4 in the round-robin stage, losing to Switzerland, Canada, South Korea and Russia. But they beat South Korea in Wednesday's tiebreaker to book a place in the last four. So they went up against the favourites, Canada. And a bit of a surprise early on with Switzerland 2-0 up after the first three ends. After blanking the first end, Canada gave up two steals to trail 2-0. Canada, remember, had gone 9-0 in the group phase. Big favourites here. Canada also beat Switzerland 6-4 in the preliminary phase. There were some signs of a surprise early on. Switzerland 2-0 up after three ends, and there was no scoring in the fourth. Canada led by Brianne Meakin from the University of Manitoba. Meakin, a four-time Manitoba junior champion and a one-time Canadian junior champion in 2009. Also won a silver medal at the World Junior Curling Championships. Meakin, the daughter of 1995 world champion Rob Meakin. She was also the flag bearer for Canada at these games. In the fifth end, Meakin made a draw to the button to score a deuce, and the teams headed into the break tied at 2-2. 24-year-old Meakin going alongside Lauren Horton, Lynn Kreveziak and Jessica Armstrong, all from the 2014 CIS champions Carleton University Ravens from Ottawa. The Swiss here looking to reassert their lead. But in the fifth, Canada right back in it at 2-2. Canadians are big favourites, certainly to at least get to the final. And Brian Meakin's team getting back into it here at 2-2. So the Swiss, they were led by Michelle Yagi. Yagi, a former Swiss junior champion. She's from the EHSM, Swiss Federal Institute of Sport. Yagi also won bronze 2 years ago in Trentino when the Swiss beat Team GB in the bronze medal game. Yagi's team also included Michelle Gribi from the University of Bern, Sina Wettstein, College of Education in Zurich, and Nora Baumann from the University of Zurich, also in the team that won bronze in Italy. In the sixth end, Canada taking control, certainly in the second half of the game, starting with a steal of three in the sixth end. And fifth and sixth ends really where this game changing and where Canada showing their class. Canada taking that lead in the sixth. Switzerland 1-0 in the seventh. Canada winning the eighth 1-0. And then in the ninth, Canada holding Switzerland after holding them to singles. Another deuce in the ninth when Yegi's final rock slid through the house. And this was to be an 8-3 win for Canada. Team Canada's women then meeting Russia in the gold medal game. Russia outclassed Sweden 10-4. And what a final that should be. This was where the Canadians wrapping up a place in the gold medal game. A little bit easier for Canada. They only just beat Switzerland 6-4 in the preliminary phase. This an 8-3 success in the Fuentenueva Pavilion. So Canada will face Russia in the final. Russia's Sidorova defeating Sarah McManus of Sweden 10-4 in the other semi-final. Switzerland against Sweden in the bronze medal game. Canada through though, they win 8-3 against Switzerland. Short track speed skating, one of the most spectacular events at the Winter Universiade. And fans at the Igloo had plenty to look forward to, the men and women competing in the 500-metre events. The finalists certainly had to work hard to get here, having to get through heats, quarterfinals and semi-finals. The track a little over 100 metres in circumference then, little room for manoeuvre, and there was plenty of action. In the women's competition, and Chinese skaters had won all three individual races at the last Universiade in 2013. Yutong Han went for China in the four women final, also looking for medals. Hakyung Song of South Korea, Anyi Serakati of Lithuania, and the Canadian Joni Gervais. This is the race then. Han number six, Son 22, Serakati 24, and the outsider from Canada, Gervais, the number one. Yutong Han from the Jilin Sports University in Changchun won her heat, quarterfinal and semi-final, a pre-race favourite. But it was Serakati from the Lithuanian Sports University in Kaunas who led for much of the race. She'd been beaten in her semi-final by the Chinese skater. And it was to prove the same way again. Gervais from the University of Quebec in Montreal a bit further back. Hakyung Song from the Korean National Sports University looking for medals. And it was Han who took over in the closing stages. She would get a second medal of the Games after winning bronze in the 1500 metres. And she also broke a Universiade record in the process, stopping the clock in 43.573 seconds. That beat the record of Hye Kyung Kim of South Korea, who set the record in 2007 in Torino, 45.56 seconds. So China continuing their domination in the women's short track. Yu Tong Han with the gold medal. And real delight for South Korea's Son, who could only come sixth in the 1500 metres final. And a real bonus for Lithuania, Anyi Serakati with the bronze medal. But Yutong Han, again proving the skater that they couldn't stop, and a gold for China. Oogie was getting the crowd going ahead of the men's 500 metres, the B race, had featured skaters from Russia, the Netherlands and Japan. But the big one saw three South Koreans going up one Chinese athlete. South Korea had won all three individual men's races in Trentino. Here they go, Yira Xiao with the number 78, Seong-Soo Han 74, Guangchen 55 and Siyoung Park 77. Three from South Korea, Chen going from China. Yi Xiao was in control for much of the race. Yi Xiao from the National Sports University. But there was to be a disaster here for his countryman, Siyoung Park, crashing out, dashing his hopes of a second gold medal. And Xiao had five wins from five races and would prove a worthy winner of the gold. Seong-Soo Han would take a second silver after coming second on the podium in the 1500 metres earlier in the week. Han had just scraped through in second place in the quarterfinals and semi-finals, so he'll be delighted with another medal. And Guang Chen also picking up a bronze in the 1500 metres, two medals for him as well. Real disappointment for Se-Seung Park, who couldn't finish, but Yida Xiao of South Korea taking the gold, Seung-Sung Han, his countryman, silver, and Guang Cheng of China with the bronze. South Korea continuing their complete domination then of men's short track skating. And if the day wasn't good enough already for Yida Xiao, he also broke the Universiade record, 41.411 seconds, breaking the record of Hyo Bin Lee, also of South Korea, in Trentino.
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.